In our Health Watch this evening, before the coronavirus pandemic hit, one of the health industry's main challenges was the nationwide opioid epidemic. In today's Health Watch, Local 5's Connie Feldman shows us some new technology in the field of pain management that's offering an alternative to opioids.
Every day, we see examples of just how far technology has come in just a few years. Today, we'll meet a Peshtigo woman who is the first person in the state to use a new technology at Aurora BayCare Medical Center called Spinal Cord Stimulation.
The pain was so intense, I couldn't hardly walk.
Like 80% of the adults in the U.S., Mary Griswas suffered from lower back pain.
I had excruciating pain and couldn't do anything like my activities like I wanted to, like walking and biking and playing golf.
And it wasn't just painful to be active. Even sleep became elusive.
Oh, I was up all night, walking the floor, and I just couldn't. I had ice packs, and I tried heat and the whole nine yards, and couldn't do it.
Dr. Howson, with the pain management team at Aurora BayCare, says Griswa's predicament is understandable.
She'd gone through a lot of the more traditional pain routes, right? Physical therapy, chiropractic, medications, different types of injections, and I think was very reasonable for her to be frustrated.
In fact, Dr. Howson says low back pain is the number one reason for disability in the United States. While Griswa's back pain was not uncommon, she did have a unique connection to the field of medical technology.
My son said, I think we can help you, Mom, and they did.
Griswa's son works for one of the companies pioneering spinal cord stimulation, or SCS, technology. Similar to a pacemaker, Dr. Howson explains how a tiny device is implanted near a patient's back.
This device uses tiny amounts of electricity to stimulate the areas of your spine that are in charge of transmitting pain signals from your low back or your leg up to your brain.
After a thorough examination, Dr. Howson determined Griswa was a good candidate for SCS, but before permanent implantation, he let her take it for a test drive.
You just wear the device on your back. It's simply just taped on with a small piece under the skin, and you get to wear it for a week and really live your life. Do the things that you want to do, some of the things you maybe couldn't do before, as a test, as a trial run to see if this device works for you.
The results?
Now I'm able to do bike riding and walking and golfing like I used to.
The method used to implant the SCS device is an outpatient procedure. It doesn't even require an overnight stay in the hospital. Griswa says she also had no hesitation going into Aurora BayCare, even in the midst of a pandemic.
They followed protocol exactly, you know, the way it should be. We all had on the face mask. They took my temperature, very, very professional.
The SCS unit is controlled by a handheld device similar to a remote control, which Dr. Howson says allows patients to adjust their own mechanism over the phone with their healthcare provider. If you'd like to know more, give Aurora BayCare a call at the number you see below or visit aurorabaycare.com. And that's your Health Watch. I'm Connie Feldman, Local 5 News.